Adopt Me just had the trade update, and in this video, I'll be showing how to get your trading license. So first, you want to go over to the Adoption Island portal, or well, the tunnel, or whatever you want to call it, but just like, go through it, and then once you're on the other side, well, you can just like, do the GPS thing, because whenever you first join on the update, it will say, hey, do you want to do the GPS to go to the thing? And then you just press yes, and then you can do that. But then, like, you gotta go over to this area over here. There's this building right here. And then once you're over here, well, I already did this on my main, and I got the safety trading badge thing. I don't know exactly where it is in your inventory, but it's hiding somewhere, probably. But, like, it allows you to trade ultra rare and legendary pets. So, yeah, you can see it right here. Trade license. And then if you click it, then you can see all of your trades. So my last two trades were just my friends giving me some random things. But like, if you go over here, you can see your trade history, and then you can press here, and then like, you can report, but that's not really the point of this video. The point of the video is how to get the trading badge. So to get the trading badge, you have to go over to the Agent Jake guy, and then he says, "Hello citizen, welcome to the safety hub." And then, like, the dialogue takes a bit for the next dialogue bubble to come up. And then he says, "You got your trading license." Anyways, if you continue the dialogue, he just says some more stuff about trading or scammers or something like that. But I'm on my alt right now, and I'll be showing you how to get it if you don't have it yet. So, well, you can't get it if you already do have it, so I'll just be showing you how to get it originally. So, like, you go over to this guy, he says, "Hello, citizen, welcome to the safety hub." And then the chat bubbles take a while to appear, but then he says, "Behind this door is the trade license test. If you don't pass your first time, don't worry, you can retake it as many times as you need to pass." So in my video about saying this stuff for this update and showing this stuff and like everything before this happened, because like Adopt Me did a video on everything, so I was just making a video like talking about it and saying how I think it will work. But like in that video, I said that it would be bad if you can only take it once, because if you like accidentally choose the wrong one, then you might not be able to trade. So anyways, now after all that dialogue, then you can go in this room. And then in this room, you're going to see, well, it looks pretty nice, but there's also a trading test. So, like, first you have to go over to the Agent Alex guy, and he says, "Would you like to start the test? You can retake it at any time if you don't pass." So, I don't know if you can actually choose. Oh, yeah, you can choose. So, you just press yes, and then it will say, "My dream pet is a Shadow Dragon." And then, I don't know what this guy is, but, like, he looks very creepy for some reason. But it shows your avatar on the left, so I think it might be different for everyone, I don't know. So, like, just do whatever you think, but, like, it's kind of obvious to be able to choose which one's a scam and which one's not a scam. Like, this one, it's just two normal pets being traded, so that's obviously safe. Well, I'm not sure how rare they are. If they're two normal pets and one of them isn't good and one of them is good, then, like, yeah, don't, but... The next is me saying that I'm giving away my dog, and then he says for free, and then I'm saying that I have an extra, and so then the weird gray tall man is saying, okay, and then that's not a scam, I guess, because like, I'm giving something to someone, how would that be a scam? And they didn't like ask for it or anything, I just randomly told them. And then this one, "Whoa, I just found this glitch. If you accept the trade and the unicorn, then it gives you Robux. Whoa, Robux, big Robux, ooh." Okay, so anyways, yeah, that's kind of obviously a scam. If you press the accept button twice, it would do literally nothing, and well, yeah, so... Anyways, now I'm just gonna wait for the thing to come up and then say that it's a scam. So is this trade safe? Scam, nope, not safe. Okay, so at the very end, after you do your quiz thing, which I think it might be different for everyone, so just like do it based on whatever it says for you. If it's a scam, then well, just choose the scam button. If it's not a scam, then don't choose the scam button. Choose the regular accept button or like... I don't remember what it was called. Not scam safe. Yeah, it was safe. Okay. So, anyways, at the end, you'll see this thing, and then it says claim, and whenever you press it, then it will give you this, and it is the trading license. So, if you go over here, and then to this category, then you will see the trade license, which is common. Of course, well, you're not able to trade it. And then if you go back and try to like get another one or something, which I already showed earlier, then it won't let you. So you can only take the test once if you pass it, but if you fail, then you can take it multiple times. And then it's actually very useful to have the trade license, even though it is common, so it's gonna be like at the bottom here. Then, well, whenever you do equip it, when you click with it, then it will show you your trade history. And on my alt, I don't really have any trades since the update happened, so I can't like go under there or click there to find that out. But like, if you're wondering, what is the use for the trade license? Well, you're not able to trade your ultra rare and legendary pets unless if you have the trade license. So like, I don't really get how that makes much sense. I don't know if it's a glitch or something, but whenever you're trading someone, they can offer the ultra rare and legendary pet. So it seems, well, I don't know, that's kind of weird. It seems like since they're trying to prevent scammers, scammers could still get ultra rare and legendary pets without the trading license. And then with the trading license, you can still get scammed, I mean, because like you can still, like, I don't really know. But you have to go over here and identify scams and not scams, so I guess that's good. But I think maybe it would be kind of safer if you had to get the trading license to receive stuff, because scammers could still scam just as easily, kind of. But there are a few more things involving with trading that like stop scammers from doing the scam thing, because it asks, is this trade fair and stuff in the menu. So there are a lot of things. This update made it a little bit harder to trade, but it's going to stop scammers almost altogether, hopefully. And if anyone does scam, then they're probably gonna get banned or punished or like something like that. So yeah, the trade license is just to make sure that you won't get scammed, and it allows you to trade your good pets. Or actually, I guess that makes sense, because like, if you know not to get scammed, then you're able to trade your good pets. And if you don't know, like if you get it wrong, and then you don't know what a scam is, then you're not allowed to trade your good pets so that you won't get scammed. I mean, yeah, that does make sense. Also, for some reason, I didn't get the GPS thing on this account. Whenever I got the trading license on my main, originally whenever I first joined, it gave me the GPS option. It said, do you want to activate the GPS to go over to the safety hub, which is this thing? And then I said yes, and then I could find it very easily. But for some reason, I didn't get the notification to activate GPS to go to the safety hub on this account. Also, I'm not entirely sure if you're able to trade stuff that's legendary and ultra rare if it's not a pet. Like, for example, trading legendary vehicles if you don't have the trading license. So I think that it might just be for pets, but I'm not entirely sure about that, because, well, I have the trading license on both of my accounts now, so I can't really see if I can. But anyways, I guess that's how to get the trading license and everything about the trading license that I know of. So make sure to subscribe with the notifications on for more Adopt Me videos, because I do Adopt Me videos. Well, I'm trying to do them daily right now, but I'm probably going to continue doing them daily, and also sometimes multiple times a day. And like the video, and I'll see you all in the next video.